I'll do another offset, 12 inches. My bad. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5x5 grid. Super. Now let's talk about this problem for a moment and just kind of let's get some opinions as to how you might go about this.
I personally use the arms first.
Nice. So the one thing we learned was this 3.5 inches really represents the distance between any one of these lines. You certainly could. I'm not sure how that would work, but we can give it a try. Okay. What do we seem to see? I see a tangent and a tangent. And it seems to be a nice arc. If I'm tangent here and here, if I were to continue this out, do you think that these would be tangent? Probably not. Can I do a tan-tan circle without a radius? Let's make sure we understand. You may have some trouble drawing this symbol, but it will make you reflect on the many commands you've covered. It says 3.5 inches between lines. All other dimensions can be approximated so that your drawing looks as close as this one possible. Okay, so kind of back to sketching rules. There's no right or wrong here as long as our work represents as close as possible what we see on the screen. Well, I kind of know something else. Well, yeah, that's a good observation, Jim. I'm going to take this arc right here, kind of go back to what Greg said, and I'm going to say, you know what? If the distance between these two is 12, and I'm not quite half, what if I make that from this distance to that tangent point, 1.5 feet.
Okay.
So now I have a tangent, and the 1.5 feet gives me a radius. So let's do a tan-tan radius circle. Tangent, tangent, with a 1.5 feet radius. How's that feel? Now I'll take that and I will use the offset command. And my offset now is going to be 3.5 quotation marks. And it seems I have my wheel. It seems that if I get close enough to this, it doesn't actually look like it intersects that grid precisely on the line, does it? It's off just a little bit. And it looks like this one's about maybe an inch. In other words, could I fit another 11 in between here and here? Looks like I probably could. So I'm going to do another offset. This time it's going to be 1 inch. I'll do an offset again. Well, dang gummit, Jim. Okay. I took this grid line and I offset it 1 inch. Now I'm going to grab this line that I just created, offset again, 3.5 inches. That's my grid line. That's the line above. That's the line below. And you know, I'm just going to I'm going to call it right here, and I'm going to say this point between this horizontal line and this vertical line is going to intersect on that grid. And I'm going to place a line and I'm going to approximate. I'm going to go up above it. Now the total distance I need is 4'2". So what I am going to do is I'm going to do an offset now of 4'2", enter, and I'm going to select this lowest horizontal line where the wheel is sitting. There it is right above. So that's the total height of this buggy. And out of that, looks to me like I got to do another tan-tan radius. I can't really do a tan-tan-tan, but I'm going to do a tan-tan radius circle. Tangent, tangent, and I'm going to make my radius this time 5 inches. Does that feel a little large? It does, doesn't it? So let me try this again. Tan, tan, radius. Tan, tan, radius, 4 inches. That feels a little better. And I'm going to use my offset, and I'm going to offset 3.5 inches. Now I have to account for the wheelchair arm. So I'm going to grab a line. I'm going to make that line tangent to this top circle. Actually, I'm not going to do it that way. I'll grab a line, but I'll make it to the quadrant and just run it out. And then I will do an offset, 3.5. my object, there it is. And it looks like I'm going to take that out about and I'm going to cap that line. And it looks like I have at a point that intersects about midway coming through the midpoint here. I'm starting to get myself in a little bit of trouble here, so I'm going to take my object snap and I'm going to turn them off. I'll just use my F3 and I'm going to rely only on my single use snaps from this point. Now, is anything that I'm doing wrong according to the intel that I have?
No.
No. And I'm going to grab another line. I'm going to place this line at the end point. And I'm going to bring that line perpendicular to that endpoint. Except that I seriously blew that. Endpoint to perpendicular. Ugh. I know. I'm being particular right now. I shouldn't be, huh? But I will take that line. Looks like to about there. Offset again. 3.5. That object. Now I'll place a line, snap to endpoint to perpendicular. That still wants the endpoint. Never mind. Another line, endpoint, perpendicular, Oh, I still don't feel very good about that. Okay. Wow. It's odd that it's perpendicular on the screen and it's so wrong to me. I'm going to start trimming away some stuff.
Did you do that at 45?
No, not really. It was more like 30. And I'll grab that line again. I'll go perpendicular to that line.
You got your, so you're out there far enough, what's your measurement?
You mean the distance across the two? 3.5.
No, for the 3.7, for how wide it is, that your toes look to touch that.
Oh, you mean here?
You put the line up there for 4'2", and then across mm-hmm. you did 3'7". Where's your line for that one?
Ah. Good point, my friend Ferris. 3'7". Take that line and place that line. Well, I'm pretty.
Oh, look at that.
I'm pretty close.
Oh, dang.
Crisscross applesauce. Except it looks terrible. Looks like barf. I can't do that. The angle of the dangle is killing me.
Yeah, but you have to train.
I'm just saying. I don't like it. It's not good, Goose. I'm out. But I am going to go to the intersection where that 3'7" ends up being, right? Out there, isn't it? You like that? I like that. What was that, David? Well, I certainly could do that. Absolutely. Or I could make it parallel with that line, and I could do that by doing an offset. 3.5 inches. Enter, select objects, there it is. And time to get some trim. That didn't come out right. Looks like I better stop. You can go all the way to the end of 4 if you want to. I'm fine with that. So I'm going to offset. Are you done? Okay, you can go on to 4-2. Do it. And I'm going to offset. Looks like I have about... if the distance between each is 3'5", I'm going to make this offset 2 inches. And the reason I'm doing that is so that I can trim. The end. And you can start to see now where I'm starting to kind of sort of get How am I doing, Greg?
Pretty good.
Almost like I kind of semi-knew what I was doing. Thanks. Wouldn't go that far? I don't blame you. No, I don't know what the heck I'm doing. I don't need that at all. I'm just a crazy guy, I'll tell you. Trim. And of course. It'll be posted. Won't it, Tim?
Yeah. Say, put John's name in. DFT24, space 2, space 18, space 2014.
Are you a genius? Tell me about your geniusness. Uh-huh. Oh, look what I managed to do. Okay. No.
He's handicapped.
Only its operator, it seems to be. Yikes.
Then we got to get rid of all the grid lines, right?
Yeah. Well, I'm just a busy, busy guy here.
I feel better now.
Well, you guys were all worried that I was just going to snap this thing together some quick way. You don't have a lot of information to work with, do you?
No, I didn't.
Right? Here's another aspect of it. You can see how much trouble I'm having because I'm having trouble depicting different lines to different things. How am I going to overcome that? Starts with L and ends with S. Layers. Right? Oh. What would happen if I had different colors here?
Oh.
Would have been easier, right? I would have known right away.
I thought of that, but when you screw it off, it would be the same color.
Greg, how am I doing? Am I getting confused? Again? I can tell you why. It's because I got to get rid of some of this crap. That's meaningless, right? Nope, wrong. Oh, now I feel better. That would help, wouldn't it? Hmm. Now, are there more easier and better ways to do this? Well, I'm sure there probably are. Huh?
Buy a handicap.
I could do it the way it said it to do in the book? Why didn't you tell me that? Well, we don't really call it guesswork, Tim. We call it educated guesstimation. We throw a little Kentucky windage at it. Am I starting to look kind of like it's sort of supposed to look?
Have you had 3.5 inches between that armrest and the
leg? I better. I hope so. Really? You can kind of see, just, you know, get a feel for how much you got to trim away. See what I just did?
That's a gate or a fence.
That'd be a fence. So that's the end. It grabs every portion of everything you just touched. That one?
Yeah.
You have to have the entire line segment enclosed.
I know, but what's it called?
Uh-huh. It's escaped me at the moment, kids. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Long day. Not gonna lie.
It's not a gate, right?
No, that
you call them gate in advance, right? For some reason that's what that
sounds good. Well, Greg, I'm taking it. As good news, you're leaving. You don't feel compelled to berate me.
No.
Good.
Can you do homework?
Nope.
Okay.
You're going to come on back. We're going to do this again on Thursday. Hey, now I feel like I got me a wheelchair. Yeah. Mine looks pretty close to that, don't it?
I can fix it for you.
Fix it?
Yeah.
Come on in.
3.5 inches off it.
Water's fine.